myself, man, what is my real passion? My real passion is somewhere else. I came out of it. So I've answered these two questions. So I repeat again. 47% people voted for one simple idea that they're not satisfied with the job profile. So your confusion is very simple today. Number one confusion is write down exactly what will satisfy you. Clearly write down what sort of job hours you want, what sort of job profile you want, what sort of, and then whether it is there or not, that is part two. We'll figure out how to find it out. First, write it down. Clearly write it down. Okay? So if you don't know, I'll tell you. When I passed out from IIT, I made an algorithm. I am a good in algorithms. So I made well, sari achhi ladkiyan ko koi na ho to ladka pasand kar liya ga usko. So koi achhi ladki to bachegi nahi market mein. To jo bachegi, bakwasi bachegi. And trust me, that's like that. I'm telling you, the most of the entrepreneurs, they think like that only. So I'll not get good people. So I'll just compromise only on any people which are coming. So let me compromise. Your life is gone, man. What compromise are you talking about? Oh, let me compromise. I'll not get a good job anywhere. Java na to whatever it is, okay? No. That's not life. No compromise. So first decision is no compromise. So I'll give you now 5 steps. Let me give you step number one. Step number one is write down your notes, check it out. Make an agreement with God that next year you are not going to live a by default life. You will design your life. I repeat again. Next year, I am not going to live a by default life. I am living a designed life. When I say designed life, I have designed it. I have wrote it down. What sort of people I want? What sort of project I want? What sort of work I want? I have designed it. It's not there, no problem. I will figure it out. I'll find out a way where I can create my own things. Why not? Who is stopping me? It is me. I can decide today and I can make it tomorrow. It's possible. I have done it and you can do it as well. If you believe you cannot do it, stay with me for 1 year. I will make it happen for you.
And we also have a very special talk today by Vishal as an invited guest talk. We'll soon hear from him as well.
Wonderful. So people who have prepared, please raise your hand so that we can call you. Second. Good. As usual, Lalita ji, apni Virender seva gaye. Every time she raises hand first. Charanjit, good. Great. So Lalita ji, aapse shuruaat kar dete. I'll just spotlight you.
Okay. Hello, everyone. As you know, I am Lalita, and today's my topic is very interesting. So, okay, who all are thinking that everything is okay in their life? Anyone always okay in their life? Anyone है जिसकी life में हमेशा हर चीज सही होता है, कभी कुछ गड़बड़ नहीं होता? No one, right? कुछ ना कुछ प्रॉब्लम हर किसी की लाइफ में होती है, राइट? तो हम क्या सोचते हैं उस मोमेंट में कि हमारी लाइफ में ऐसी प्रॉब्लम क्यों आ रही है? मैंने तो कभी कुछ ऐसा किया ही नहीं कि हमारे साथ में ऐसी प्रॉब्लम आए, ठीक है? बट हमें ये नहीं पता होता कि जो रूट कॉज है ना, वो हमारे ही अंदर है. हम ही सारी प्रॉब्लम्स के जड़ हैं. हम लोग जब हमारा प्रमोशन नहीं होता तो हम बॉस को बोलते हैं कि बॉस बहुत गंदा है, हमारा प्रमोशन नहीं करता है. मैरिज अगर किसी ऐसी लड़की से हो जाए जो आपको सूट ना करे तो आप बोलते हो यार मेरी किस्मत ही खराब थी. मेरे साथ ही ऐसी प्रॉब्लम क्यों आती है? मैं तो कुछ भी किसी के साथ गड़बड़ नहीं करता हूँ, कुछ भी गलत नहीं करता, बट क्यों होता है? सो हाई गाइज, डू यू नो दिस ऑल थ्रू अ लॉ ऑफ अट्रैक्शन. लॉ ऑफ अट्रैक्शन है जो पूरे यूनिवर्स में, जिसके थ्रू ये सारी चीजें आपकी लाइफ में होती है. हर कोई सोचता है मैं परफेक्ट हूँ, बट नोइंगली अनोइंगली हम कुछ ऐसा कर बैठते हैं जिसका रिजल्ट हमारी लाइफ में होता है, राइट? तो सबने न्यूटन का लॉ पढ़ा होगा ना, थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. डू यू रिमेम्बर व्हाट इज दैट? एवरी एक्शन इज इक्वल एंड अपोजिट रिएक्शन, राइट? सबको याद होगा. एक छोटा सा सेंटेंस है, बट इस सेंटेंस में इतनी सारी चीजें हाइड है कि अगर आप समझोगे ना तो वही चीजें हमारी लाइफ में भी इम्पैक्ट करेगी. आपने देखा होगा जब भी कोई बॉल आप ऊपर थ्रो करते हो तो वो एक टाइम के बाद नीचे जरूर आती है. व्हाई? क्योंकि एक लॉ ऑफ अट्रैक्शन है, अर्थ जो उसको अट्रैक्ट कर रही है. डिपेंड करता है कि वो बॉल कितने ऊपर तक गई है, कितने हाइट तक गई है. ऐसे ही हमारी लाइफ में हर चीज होती है. जो भी चीजें हम करते हैं, चाहे वो फिजिकली हो या मेंटली हो, हमारी लाइफ को इम्पैक्ट करती है. बिकॉज जब हम कुछ सोच रहे होते हैं या कोई भी फिजिकल वर्क कर रहे होते हैं तो क्या होता है, उसी टाइप की एनर्जी रिलीज होती है जो यूनिवर्स में जाती है और फिर वो रिफ्लेक्ट होती है, राइट? तो पहले जब हम चाहते हैं कि हमारा जो रिजल्ट है वो राइट हो, तो इसके लिए पहले हमें अपने एक्शन को चेंज करना होगा जिससे हमें उसका पॉजिटिव रिजल्ट मिले। तो जैसे मैंने पहले ही बोला कि हर किसी को यही लगता है कि मैंने कुछ गलत नहीं किया फिर भी मेरी लाइफ में ऐसा हो रहा है, तो क्या रीजन हो सकता है उसका। तो लॉ ऑफ अट्रैक्शन है, इस चीज को अगर आप समझ जाओगे तो आप कभी भी कुछ मिस्टेक करोगे ही नहीं। तो कैसे हम अपने जो फ्यूचर में जो मिस्टेक हो रही है उसको कैसे करेक्ट कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि जो हमने किया है उसका फल तो हमें मिलेगा ही, उसको तो हम करेक्ट कर ही नहीं सकते हैं। जो हमने कर्म किया है तो जो भी सीड हमने सो किया है वो तो पेड़ बनेगा ही, बट जो आगे होने वाला है एटलीस्ट उसको हम रोक सकते हैं, राइट। तो कैसे रोक सकते हैं उसके लिए कुछ पॉइंट्स मैं आप आज कवर करूंगी। ओके, टुडे ये आपको वर्ड्स यूज करना है और लर्न करना है। टुडे आई विल विटनेस द चॉइसेस आई मेक इन ईच मोमेंट एंड इन द मेयर विटनेसिंग ऑफ दीज चॉइसेस I will bring them to my conscious awareness. I will know that the best way to prepare for any moment in the future is to be fully conscious in the present. And second point is, whenever I make a choice, I will ask myself two questions. First is, what are the consequences of these choices that I am making? And second one is, will this choice bring fulfillment and happiness to me? And also, to those who are affected by these choices. And last point is, I will then ask my heart for guidance and be guided by this, by its message of comfort or discomfort. If the choices feel comfortable, I will plug ahead with abundance. And if the choices feel uncomfortable, I will pause and see the consequences of my action with my inner vision. This guidance will enable me to make correct choices for myself and for all the around me. So all these points which is alert us कि क्या सोचना है हमको, कैसे एक्शन लेना है कि हमारा फ्यूचर ब्राइट हो सके और हमें मिस्टेक नहीं करना है, क्योंकि आपने सुना होगा कि जैसा बोया वैसा पाया। तो ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है। दिस इज द लॉ ऑफ कर्मा फ्रॉम द बुक ऑफ 7 स्पिरिचुअल लॉ ऑफ सक्सेस बाय द दीपक चोपड़ा। थैंक यू सो मच।
अमेजिंग ललिता जी, एज यूजुअल बहुत ही अच्छे से आपने एग्जांपल लिया लॉ ऑफ अट्रैक्शन एंड देन यू साइटेड लॉट ऑफ एग्जांपल। आपने जो सेल्फ टॉक आई थिंक बताया था उसको आप शेयर कर देना ग्रुप में, आई थिंक दैट इज रियली गुड सेल्फ टॉक टू प्रैक्टिस। थैंक यू सो मच ललिता जी।
Thank you.
Great. So we'll move to the next speaker. So I think before we can move, we can take a couple of new people introduction. I think a lot of people have joined right now. Ajay, are you joining for the first time, Ajay?
Yes.
Okay, great. So Ajay, if you don't mind, can you introduce yourself to us? Your name, your profession, who invited you, and where do you locate?
Yeah, myself Ajay Kumar, and I'm from Jharkhand, but staying in Bangalore from last 10 years.
Wow.
And currently working in Capgemini. It's around 4 years already completed.
Oh, that's nice. And who invited you, Ajay?
I don't remember his name.
Okay, cool, no issues. Anyway, in case jinnone bhi invite kiya, aap connect back kar lena, and or else you can connect to me later. Great, thank you Ajay for sharing the introduction. Cool. Chandramani, you can also introduce yourself quickly as people have joined now.
Yeah, hi everyone, this is Chandramani from Bangalore. Actually I'm from Madhya Pradesh, but staying in Bangalore past 12 years. And I am invited by Bhushan Singh, and it's been very nice to meet you all because I am the avid book reader, so I just love it, this concept, and really I really like a pleasant night today, like it's like to meeting all of you, and really like the way this our Biren Sehwag has been, sorry, I forgot the name, Lalita ji, right? Lalita ji. Yeah. So, yeah, actually, even today I was reading those things, Law of Attraction, and I just got the glimpse of those things. So, just like what I say, I just read about the law of attraction, and just night itself, I got something about that.
The law of attraction worked right
away. Yeah, it's working. Thank you all. Thanks a lot, Bhushan, and thank you all.
Thank you so much, Chandramani. So I think there's some Divakar. Divakar, have you joined for the first time as well? I would appreciate if people, while introducing, at least switch on their video so that we will at least know who we are speaking, if possible, if the bandwidth permits. Yeah. Go ahead, Divakar.
Yeah. So hi, everyone. I'm Divakar. So I work as a editor.
Hello, everyone. Very good evening and welcome to the new members to the club. Today my topic is about the third chapter from a book named Rich Dad Poor Dad. So the third chapter talks about mind your own business. So as the name indicates, mind your own business. Like most of the people like us, like we are in service sector, we are doing a job, and we have a career, and once we are done with that, we think what we have achieved actually for ourselves, right? So you are just working for someone. So author has given very good example here. He has given example of the owner of McDonald, Ray Kroc. So once I think in a chapter which is mentioned in 1974, he was invited to as a speaker in one of the university in Texas, where he explained about his business. Okay, once the seminar happened, and he deliberately asked to the students, okay, do you know about my business? And people didn't say anything. Students didn't say anything. But again, he shouted, do you know which business that I'm into? And then students said, Who doesn't know that you are in a business of hamburger, right? So he smiled and said, you are completely wrong. This is not my primary business. So where he mentioned about his business was more about the real estate, which he was doing parallel with McDonald's business. So what the story talks about that though he had a primary business in McDonald's, but with that he was doing the real estate business as well. So this chapter, author emphasizes on one thing only, that if you need to have a financial freedom in your life, people you have seen, they are doing a job. Okay, they are religiously doing it. Okay, for 30 or 40 years. Okay, they are brushing their skills. They want to be at a higher position in corporate world. But at the end, do they have anything what they call, this is what they have built? No, right? Because if you want something which will be called with your name, that will be your business. So author talks about here that you have to mind your own business. Like you can keep your daily job, but you have to think something, you have to think of such kind of options where you can have your own business, where you don't need to be present. You create such system which can run without your presence, okay? And which will eventually give you financial freedom. So apart from that, he has also mentioned that mostly rich people who are actually rich, I would say, they buy the luxury at the end. Like once they know okay, they have some other sources of income where they can generate some cash flows, with that they will buy some luxuries. But on the other hand, the people who just want to look like a rich people, but they are not actually a rich people. Like if I talk about the people who are in corporate world, whenever they get bonus, they try to buy some car, they want to book a flat. Okay, and they ended up buying so much debt that they will have to pay EMI throughout their life, right? So eventually what will happen, they will not get the financial freedom. They will not be in a position to take a risk in their life. So even you have heard about so many things, so many times that people said that this person has a net worth of $100 million. So when we say $100 million, it has his bungalow, it has its luxury cars, it has everything. But do you think when those things will be sold out, those will have the same value? No, right? Even the car, if you buy from showroom, very next, the moment it goes out of the showroom, it will the value of that car will be reduced by 25%. So what does it mean? Do not chase such assets which doesn't give you extra cash flow, or which is actually putting you in a debt. So instead of put some money in some business where you can create such systems and you can create a second source of income. So that is from my side, I think I would have, I have added value in the people who are listening to me. Thanks for listening to me, guys.
Thank you so much, Charanjit. Really nicely summarized the topic. In fact, the topic is pretty deep when the author tells about mind your own business. So being financial literate is very, very essential. And as we know, no need to say the situation's currently going on in the market. It is a need of the hour. So thank you so much, Charanjit, for sharing your topic. Wonderful. So we can quickly go to the next person then. So our Iron Man, we call him. So Bhushan, you'll go next. I'll spotlight you.
Hi everyone, myself Bhushan. And last time Sahana spoke about imagination. So today I will talk about my journey, how this imagination actually helped me and working for me, okay? So as Albert Einstein said, through the knowledge you can reach A to B point, but through the imagination you can get everywhere. So actually I want to share my story so that you can relate, okay? Not theoretical. So actually I belong to a very middle lower class family. My parents are uneducated. And by the high, my high school, I got the desire ki yaar mujhe ek school banana hai apne gaon ke liye. So that maine jaise struggle kiya, so that mere gaon ke log struggle na kare, coming generation. So that I will give the free education. And after I thought ki I will become the engineer, and my mom desire was I should become a teacher. So main kya sochta tha ki if I will become the teacher, I will help some people only, limited people. So if I will become the engineer, I will have the money, I will open the school and I can hire multiple teacher. That was my imagination and dream. And after 10 plus 2, I got the admission in one of normal college. And I left that college within 1 month. And during that 1 month, I was just thinking, okay, what will happen? What will happen in my life if I will not become a engineer? I will not open my school and life will be end like that. No one will know me, okay? So that was my imagination. And when I left that college, my parents and society mujhe samajhne lage ki yaar ye stupid hai, ye kuch bhi nahi kar sakta life, man. And after that, I was out of study for 3 years because no one supported me, and because of lack of money, lack of the guidance. And those 3 years I had a struggle, very struggle time, okay? But I used to just imagine I will open that school, how that school will be, kaise padhai hogi mere school mein, kaise mere gaon ke log jab bahar nikalenge to they can compete anywhere. That was the my dream and imagination. And by the God grace, and kuch cousins ne help kiya, and then I became the engineer. And after that, after 2 to 3 years, I understood ki yaar, this job will cannot fulfill my dream. Mere family ke liye acha hai, khane ke liye acha hai, but what about my dream? Jiske liye maine engineering padhai kiya hai. Because my aim was not in engineering. And I started to thinking again what I should do. I'm working on it. And even though I was very average student, not a brilliant, okay? But that imagination and the desire brought me there to here. Today also, maine apne diwal mein, ghar ke diwal mein, bathroom mein, maine us image ko laga ke rakha hai. And every day I just stand for 5 minutes एंड मैं इमेजिनेशन करता हूँ उसकी, जो मैं पहले करता था कि कैसा होगा वो स्कूल, आई मीन कैसे टीचर होगी, कैसे मैं कैसे पढ़ाया जाएगा उस स्कूल में, और मेरे अंदर फीलिंग पैदा हो जाता है. ओके, तो माई लाइफ इज लाइक मिशन. टूडे आई ऑल्सो इमेजिन सेम. आई वॉन्ट टू शेयर वन मोर इमेजिनेशन, ओके, विच विल हैपन विथ एवरी वन. सो वन डे विल इन द डेथ बेड. सबको होना है डेथ बेड में, राइट? दैट इज द ट्रू. एंड टू सीनरी वुड बी वन सीनरी ये हो सकता है कि विल फील वेरी सैड, रिगार्ड, रिग्रेट्स, कॉज मैन मे बी आई कुड हैव डन दिस, आई कुड हैव अचीव दिस, पीपल विल नॉट रिमेंबर मी, एंड सैडली एंड यू नो अनसेटिस्फाइड यू विल लीव द वर्ल्ड वन डे. सेकेंड सीनरी कुड बी यू फील लाइक द चैंपियन, यू अचीव वट एवर यू वॉन्टेड टू, एंड world will remember you, even coming generation will remember you, and after you will leave this world happily and satisfied, you will leave the world, even after the left the world you can talk to the God ki maine jo karna tha maine kar dikhaya. So that is the power of the imagination, and we all have that tool by God gifted, but we sometimes use in the negative way. So life is our choice, is our use this potential, and so many times we are stuck in the just logical mind and current situation. We don't see our future and desire and dream. So thank you very much for listening to me. Hope it is added some value. Thank you very much, Kiran.
Amazing, Bhushan. In fact, people were speechless. Whoever put on the video, I can see them, but then just video nahi laga, unko to nahi pata. But yeah, it was truly amazing, Bhushan. You really stand up with your strengths and the visualization which you carry for yourself. I think bahut logo clarity mil gaya hoga. In fact, people were struggling to write down mere dreams. Main kaise likhu, how will I visualize? You showed the live example. How do you visualize your dream and write it down and follow through it? And that is a live example for most of us who have not started doing it. So thank you so much, Bhushan, for sharing your story. This will be a really great help. So definitely we have a couple of more talks similar to this, so that again jo hamara main essence hai ki bhai logo ko yaar wo baitha hua jo lion hota hai na, wo baag, wo zakhmi baag ko utha ke nikalna hai, tehlka machao bhai, kya baith ke aise kya kar rahe ho. Very nicely shared, Bhushan, awesome. So we'll move to the next speaker. Nasir, you'll go next.
Yeah, okay.
Cool.
So I'll be speaking about chapter 5, specialized knowledge from Think and Grow Rich. So the author talks about there are two types of knowledge. One is general knowledge and one is specialized knowledge. And generally all the professionals like doctors, engineers, they have specialized knowledge, and from this knowledge they make their earnings and they chase their dreams. And general knowledge is knowledge most of the people will be having, but it doesn't enable us to earn money from general knowledge, though it might be helpful in day to day life. And on a lighter note, maybe if you get a chance in KBC, you will get a chance to win some crores of rupees using general knowledge. So knowledge will not attract money unless it is organized and intelligently directed through. This is the crux of the chapter. So if you see all the lecturers, professors in universities, colleges and all, they have specialized knowledge, but they would be earning a limited salary, and within that salary, it's difficult to chase their dreams, right? So the gap here comes mainly because our educational institutes are not designed. They do not take care of making sure to teach how to apply, organize this to a definite plan and make this specialized knowledge to make money. So we have false belief like knowledge is power, but in fact the knowledge is only a potential power, and knowledge becomes power only when and if it is organized into definite plans of action. So in this chapter, he also gives an example of Henry Ford. So he is, I think, school, he has not done his graduation at all, but he is one of the richest businessmen. And Ford is one of the well-known automobile company. So in one of the Chicago newspaper, it was published, they named him as an ignorant pacifist. So he did not like that, and he filed a suit against the newspaper. So while during the hearing of this newspaper, that advocate from the newspaper side, he started to answer all general knowledge questions to show that Henry Ford doesn't have any knowledge. So at one point, Henry Ford got annoyed, irritated with these questions, and he told, like, if you want to continue, you can continue asking these stupid questions and I can answer, but I would like to tell you, like, I have a switch on my table, and it has a buttons, so I can call people, summon people to help me, whatever knowledge I am needing at that point. So right now, same way, Google is there for us. Even if we don't have knowledge on our own, but we can Google and find ways for ourselves. And one real life example, I would like to conclude with a real life example of Dhirubhai Ambani. So he left education once he came to know, like, education won't be enough to become rich. Then he went to Africa, and then he gained specialized knowledge. Then he returned back and he started his private company. And it was one of the first private company to cross 10 lakh, lakhs turnover. So educate is derived from Latin word educo. So that means to develop from within. So I will conclude with this. Thank you.
Very precisely covered, Nasir. I'm really liking it, because every time you're speaking, your confidence level, everything is increasing step by step. And I've also watched your live session with Karthik. And I think who was there? Saurabh was also there with live session. Really good, man. Both of you did a great job. I couldn't hear completely, but I've heard both of you speaking. So I'm really liking the way the confidence level you both are increasing on yourself. It's a wonderful effort, both of you. Thank you so much, Nasir, for sharing.
Yeah, look.
Great. So we can move to the next speaker. We can take Vinay. You want to go next? Vinay, if you can hear me, in case you're there. Okay. In case you're not there, we can take it later. And I think we do.
Yeah, I went to washroom.
No issues. Vinay, we'll do one thing. We have our guest speaker already there. So we'll quickly take him, and then after that, we'll take it. Okay. So before inviting our guest speaker, let me just share a brief background about him. So he's none other than Vishal Andalkar. And I know Vishal for almost 3+ years now. And he's one of the wonderful coaches in PIM community, as well as he has tremendous experience in corporate. He's more into aerospace industry, more than 10+ years of experience. And tremendously humbled personality with lot of wisdom in his pocket. As well as, when I say wisdom, it's not about theoretical wisdom. It is an on-field action wisdom. And the best part about what Vishal I like about is that the persistence mindset he carries. And you won't even realize, even if he has stress in his life, aap Vishal ko kabhi bhi us stressful chehre mein dekhoge nahi. Har vakt unka chehra smiling hi rahega. Every time, whenever I see his face will be smiling and emitting happiness and positivity. That is a special thing which I have learned from Vishal. And with no delay, I'll just invite Vishal to share his topic, because this topic is very, very important for all of us to really grow in our life. So Vishal, up to you. Stage is yours.
Thanks, Kiran. This is a great way to introduce, actually. Yeah. So yeah, I'm seeing many young people in this book club. So I think this is one of the book club under PIM. We have so many young people. So India generation will be secured, you know, because in next 5 years you people will be leaders. And that too with Kiran, Kartik Sahana, Bhushan, all buddies. Actually, I personally know them because we are together on this platform for personal growth. Okay, so coming back to the topic. So today I'm here to convey the one message, and that is related that one of the important trait for your personality I'm going to discuss here. And that is so important that it is also not like that one, it is everything. But trust me, without this, you can achieve nothing. So it is that much important. And that is your self-esteem. Okay. So and self-esteem has actually impact on many areas of your life. So what is a self-esteem? First of all, we will try to understand what is a self-esteem. It is a degree to which you love and respect yourself as a human being. Simple. But in today's world, you see, morning to evening or weekdays or sometime weekend also, do we really spend time with ourselves? Though in this world, who is the best person to talk with? Ourselves. But are we giving a compliment to ourselves daily? Are we talking to ourselves daily? No, actually, most of us, 99% people are actually not doing it. So that is what actually self-esteem comes to picture. Because if we do not love and respect ourselves, how can we do with others that same thing? Law of attraction works like that one. So it is not going to happen. So why it is so important? First thing is like you try to ask this question to yourself. What outcome you want in your life? Or what do you want to achieve in your life? It's a simple question. Based on your self-esteem, your answer will be from 2 BHK house to maybe it is like a achieving the intangible, so many things. So low self-esteem people, they will be focusing on 2 BHK house and one car. Like I was before introducing to the PIM, I was like that. Very narrow thinking, small thinking. And that is because of low self-esteem. But if you ask this question to a person with a high self-esteem, he is going to answer, I want to impact the world. I want to add value to the people. I want to have a villa. Why just 2 BHK house? I want to go for a world tour. And in Peak Impact Mentorship Workshop, you might have heard from the BJG that he wanted to have financial independence. Why he was able to think? Because he carries high self-esteem. So next step we will discuss is how this self-esteem exactly formed. Why a people with a varying self-esteem are available around us. And one of the most important thing is like a childhood upbringing. Your own childhood upbringing is actually played an important role in shaping your self-esteem. So you just see, you remember your childhood. Is there anybody in this call whose parents always say, beta, tu kuch bhi kar sakta hai. Tu bas matlab ki jeetne ke liye paida hua hai. You are going to conquer the world. You take the risk. Whatever you do, we are here to support you. ऐसा किसी पेरेंट्स ने डेली बोला था मतलब हर काम के लिए? मेरे पेरेंट्स ने तो बोला था भाई रिस्क अपने मतलब की लेवल की नहीं है, हमारे लिए नहीं है. यू डू दिस थिंग्स, यू डू नॉट डू दैट थिंग, दैट्स इट. सो विद दैट माइंडसेट, सो व्हाट एवर द सेल्फ एस्टीम आई गॉट डेवलप्ड, इफ सपोज इन फ्यूचर वन अपॉर्चुनिटी कम्स टू मी, हाउ विल बी माई रिस्पॉन्स? बिकॉज आई एम नॉट द रिस्क टेकर नाउ, आई रन अवे फ्रॉम द चैलेंजेस. So that's why actually self-esteem plays a very important role. But now till the teenage or crossing the teenage, that is fine. Okay. Because of uncontrollable circumstances, you got that self-esteem. But being an adult, still if we have our self-esteem at very low level or mediocre level, then only the person who are responsible is we. We are only responsible because self-esteem is the one thing which can be repaired. It is not a one-day task or two-day task. It is a process. It may take months to years, but it can be done. And today I'm here to tell you step-by-step procedure. You can do it on daily basis that how you can improve your self-esteem. So if you have pen and paper, try to write it down. It doesn't cost any money. Simple exercises, but free of cost things we don't value. That is a human nature. Maybe because our self-esteem is not that high. So without spending much time, I'll go to those steps. So first thing is do not compare yourself with others. Okay, so because we live into the world right now, people around us from the different background, cosmopolitan culture, different background, different religion, different region, their own childhood upbringing is different, different educational background maybe. So people around us are from the self, low self-esteem to the high self-esteem. And when we compare ourselves with the people who carries very high self-esteem, definitely we are going to feel inferior. So once we start feeling inferior, it means like that we don't love ourselves, we don't respect ourselves. So that is going to lower your self-esteem. So first thing is, if you want to compare you with yourself and work on how you can improve it rather than comparing yourself with others. And from the childhood, again, we have attended many exams, competitive exams. Always it is like a comparing. So that comparison is in our subconscious mind. But we have to throw that idea. Next important thing is stop putting yourself down. And there are many, many things in this you get involved. May not be related to just career. Maybe it is like your own look, your own hair, your financial situation maybe. Maybe it is like you are a senior lead, you are lead and your friend is a senior lead. Because of that one, you start putting yourself down and you use the negative affirmations, right? Ye mere liye hai nahi, mere saath hi kyun aisa hota hai, right? Matlab ki growth mere bas ki baat nahi hai, paisa kamana bahut difficult hai. So how that will have impact on you? Because your self-esteem will be anchored down with that negative thoughts. So instead of that one, you can use positive affirmations, self-affirm daily. Some of the few sentences I can tell you that you can tell, I respect myself. I'm a high competent person and I'm born to win, right? I love me. How about that? Simply telling from when you get up from the bed, when you're working in the office, or before going to the bed, you can have this self-affirmation about yourself. Maybe when you go to the toilet, then also you can say these things to you. Why not? Doesn't cost money. Simple way. Next, an important step is start associating with the positive and supporting people. In today's world, it is very, very difficult to get the association, guys. Okay, because it is a digital world. When you go to the internet, from the new channel to the Netflix, everywhere, crime news, everything is related to the crime only, 99% things. And people around us meet, they also see the same thing. So this peak impact mentorship actually played an important role with me. So when a couple of years back, when I got introduced, I was a person with a very narrow thinking, very small thinking, because my self-esteem was very less. But when I started associating with a Vijayji, who carries very high self-esteem, definitely how it is going to be after some days, at least I get a clarity. I understand first of all what it is and then work on that one, how I can improve it. Because positive people will help in shaping your thought process and vision. Okay, ek onion ki bori rehti hai, usme agar ek onion sada hua hai, so after 1 week, we have to throw entire onion back, right? So that is also negative association. Next and important thing is make a list of your past successes. However small successes, whether it is a spot award where you have earned maybe 350 rupees for that one, which doesn't cost more than one biryani. But when you remember about that thing, you feel good. You start respecting yourself. You will pat yourself, right? Or maybe you have played some crickets, maybe at a school level, zonal level, state levels, or maybe district levels also. Start remembering that one always so that you will start respecting and loving yours. Okay. So this is thing. One more thing, one important thing is make a list of your positive qualities. Okay. And one of the peak impact mentorship workshop, this exercise was given last year by Vijayji itself. Take a paper, and this is 30 second exercise. Everybody has to do it. Maybe after this, book club, you can do it. On left side, you can write down your weaknesses, and right side, you write down your strengths. The outcome of this exercise completely bowled me. You know what happened? I found myself that I have 8 weaknesses. and strength, merely three strength I was knowing about myself. So if you see, as a person, how I know about myself is I am a weak person, not the strong person, because I know eight weaknesses about me and only three strengths. John C. Maxwell says, when you want to build something big, focus on your strength. Do not try to fix every weakness, because that will be time waste. Till now, whoever achieved big success, they worked on their strength, not on the weaknesses. On the go, you can do it. So that's why make a list of your positive qualities. Very important. Next thing is start giving more. Why it is important? Am I audible, Kiran? I think some.
Yeah, Vishal.
Yeah. Okay. Other pop-up came. Yeah. Okay. So start giving more. As a human being, we took a birth. What is the first and foremost primary responsibility of ours? Giving back to the society. But when we give, when we have abundance. And when we don't have abundance, we don't give, because we believe that one, if I give, I will not be able to achieve that what I give. So it's now we have to trick our subconscious mind. Every successful person, actually he tricked his subconscious mind and stating that when you don't have anything big or major abundance, still you are giving that thing to others. Subconscious mind will understand that one, okay, I have already abundance, and that's how actually abundance will get attracted. So start giving more. It will increase your self-esteem as well. Next important thing is start getting involved into those activities which you love. It can be anything. Maybe it is a cooking. Maybe it is a sketching, drawing, painting, singing, playing cricket, or it can be other sports also, or it is a photography. See, when you start engaging the things which you love, what happens, you get actually more positive results because you are doing by heart. Suppose 10 things you try in a week in kitchen, 10 different recipes. If you are a person who loves cooking, at least 7 recipes are going to be good hit. That actually you feel yourself a proud, and that respect will be there. So that actually it is going to raise the self-esteem from one level to up next level. So last and important thing is one step is go to the action mode. Very important, because just by thinking or dreaming about the self-esteem, it is not going to raise it. We have to go into the action mode. Once we go to the action mode, whatever results we get, that result actually pump our self-esteem to the next level. And with a higher self-esteem, we actually get a better results. So in, I think 2 weeks back, one workshop happened, a peak impact mentorship workshop, there Vijayji said, once you start something, some new initiative, and when you get a positive result initial period of time, you are going to put more effort for the rest of the period. Why? Because you have more belief now, more confidence about yourself. That's how actually self-esteem plays very important role there. So for summarize purpose, I can tell first thing is stop comparing yourself with others. Second thing is stop putting yourself down. Use the self-affirmation about yourself. Next thing is associate with the positive people, positive and supportive people. I'm so happy that 20 people are there in this call where you all are working. And after work from home, hectic work from home, people are still here, not just audience, but contributing also. So that is you like the positive association. And next 6 years, 5 years, 6 years, this thing actually, it will have visible results in your life. A tremendous result, I would say. And then make a list of your positive qualities. Make a list of your past successes. Go to the action mode. Start giving more. So these are the few steps. And once you do continuously, maybe after months, 6 months or 1 year, you will find a magnificent you. Okay, that will be real you. A person who has huge potential. A person who has a better mindset towards the taking the risk. A better mindset towards failing. Because failing is the one thing which stops us taking the new initiative. Okay, so and apart from that one, with a high self-esteem, you will be the person who has a peace of mind. Very important, because when you are alone, you are going to respect yourself a lot more. So this is what I wanted to say, guys. I hope I have added value to each, every one of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Vishal. It was really priceless, the learnings which you have shared. But then, yeah, I won't speak. I'll ask a couple of people from the audience to unmute and share their key learnings, because that way we can give some gratitude to Vishal's effort. Because I think the whole week, Vishal has been going to multiple book clubs. I think close to 7-8 book clubs he goes, and he prepared very nicely and adding a lot of value to more than 300 plus people. So I really appreciate the time he has taken out for us. So anyone, you can, you know, unmute yourself quickly, you know, one or two key learnings, so that, you know, it will really help Vishal feel better, and then we can.
Yeah, Kiran. So it was really nice. And I think most of the people will have this issue of low self-esteem. Even I have faced this. So this points will definitely will help me. Don't compare with others. Focus on self-improvement and give back to the society. This points will definitely add value, and the 30-second test also will help and make sure we know our strength and weaknesses. Yeah, thank you.
Amazing, Nazgara. Amazing. Superb. Anyone else quickly? They can unmute new people who have not spoken. You unmute and you can share quickly.
Hi, Kiran. Chandramani this side.
Yeah, Chandramani.
Yeah, so the first, I thanks to our speaker. I forgot the name, sorry.
Vishal.
Thanks, Vishal. And I noted down whatever you suggested us. So I can list out, like, I can speak out all things if you want.
So you can share one key learning, Chandramani. I think just for time constraint, share okay. One key learning.
Okay. The key learning is about the self-esteem he talked about. So I just mentioned to this one, like, reading books that can help us to improving our self-esteem, like self-image we call usually in our language, and association with the positive people. Okay, so like here we are many people new, and even I am new, but I can make myself to talk to you. Even I'm just like, you can feel my voice is something shivering kind of, but even I make myself to talk to you all guys. And this John C. Maxwell, this statement, like, don't focus on weakness. So that is a very must for everyone. And one more thing I have to make it, like make list of your past success. This is very important. When you feel very low, you just think about what you have done very good in your life. I'm pretty sure everyone has done something tremendous in their life. So when they feel low esteem, they feel like a negative note, they can think about those, their success, and they can make feel better, and they can high self-esteem also. Thanks a lot, Kiran. And thanks
so much for your time. Very, very beautifully you summarized. And I would request people who have learned key learnings, do share in the chat box, because I'll, you know, take this compilation and share with Vishal, because he should know he really added a lot of value to us. And that itself will boost his self-esteem, and he can impact more and more people and keep inspiring all of us again and again. And thank you so much, Vishalji. Really, really thank you so much, because your time is very valuable to us, for coming and sharing your story as well.
Thank you so much, Kiran and all. It was wonderful to talk with you. I'm seeing chat, actually. It is already flooded. I'm feeling so happy. Thank you so much. See you. Good night.
Good night. Bye.
Bye.
Great. Cool. So that's super awesome. Self-esteem. So now people are very confident. Now let's talk about something very, very essential. You know, how do you handle your spending habit? This is something which is so practical. And this will really give you an idea how a successful guy or how a rich people actually take out their habit when it comes to finances. And this is what Karthik will cover now. So Karthik, the stage is all yours. I'll spotlight you.
Hi, Kiran. Is my voice audible?
Yes, audible.
Okay. Thank you so much. It was like wonderful sharing from Vishal. It was like silently throwing bombs. Very valuable points, actually. Today I'm going to speak about, like Kiran told, the spending habits, right?
So it's a very sensitive topic because it's about finances and from Rich Dad Poor Dad book, Robert Kiyosaki's. And so we know like our system, our society, our culture, like it has been programmed. We have to work hard. I mean, we have to study well, work hard, and focus more on the profession so that you get money and your life will settle, right? So that's how like we are developed, like work hard and spend money. And if in case any shortage is there, you borrow it. Okay, so we have spent all our efforts, all our energy, all our time more on the professions and compared to the money part, right? Because some people also tell the desire of money is a root of all evil. So something like that's a different story altogether. But yes, like what Robert tells is you have to spend some time on investments. Like, I mean, learning about money, okay? Learning about how, thinking about investment. I mean, we do invest, but have we really understood the learning and importance of investment, okay? So this Robert talks about one example. This rich woman, right, in her home, there it was burglarized, okay? So the thieves took so many stuffs like TV, materialistic, like some cash, materialistic things, so many things they all took away. But you see the important books, what this woman like became, I mean, these books which made her rich, okay? These books were left behind, okay? So if we see around also, like only 90% of us, we invest on materialistic things, but only 10% of us really invest on very important stuff, that is our mind, that is our brain, and that is the books, right? And so like Robert talks about three things, okay? One is like books. This is one thing which he shares. And the second thing is about the, he was seeing some advertisement when he was watching TV. And this, because of this advertisement, he ended up at a course, investment course, that went for 3 days, okay? He spent $385 on this course. But this 3 days of course made him like earn more than $2 million worth of money, right? So he tells that every year he spends 3-4 courses like that and invests on this so that he can make more money, okay? This is second thing. And third thing is like a podcast, like audios, right? On this financial intelligence. So he was once listening to this person, Peter Lynch, right? So when he was listening to his podcast, he like, at one point of time, he didn't agree with what the speaker was telling. And because then he thought, okay, let me leave back my arrogance and see what he's trying to tell and why I'm not able to accept it. Okay, he listened so many times to see what he was actually telling and why did he tell that? Because see, like he tells like arrogance, if it combines with intelligence, it will become like ignorant, right? So he takes some important points from that, why he told that. So that when you get new ideas to reach your goals, it's not necessary that you have to stick with your own ideas, right? If new ideas come, it will synergize, it will help you, okay, to reach your goal. So this, of course, this new ideas, new learning will also make you to make some mistakes and all that is there. So these three things he tells about the investments on books, on audios or podcasts, and he's attending some courses. And luckily, we are doing it as part of Peak Impact Mentorship, right? So this listening skills was very important for him. Because we also know like we have 2 years and one month, right? God has given. But so most of the times we do the opposite, okay? So he also tells that he admires people who invest more on mind, okay? He also knows people who invest so much on stocks, real estate. He knows them, but if the person is really investing on his mind, he really admires those people, he tells. So that is why he tells pay yourself first, right? This is taken from a book called The Richest Man in Babylon. Pay yourself first, pay yourself on your education, right? So I'll just speak about the self-discipline also before I share a small snippet. The self-discipline of making on our finances, right? He gives a small example. When you win a lottery, I think when first time KBC, I think Harshavardhan or somebody won, right? So we were so happy, like he won 1 crore. But what did he become after that? Okay, how did he spend the 1 crore? Did he become famous after that? Not sure, right? So if we make more money, suddenly we spend on some car or buying something or some stuff and on liabilities, right? So he tells that three things you have to be good in managing: management of cash flow, management of people, management of personal time. This is common for mainly for businesses or job or whatever profession you are. Management of cash flow, management of people, and management of personal time. So to end, I'll just share you one thing, how we actually spend our money, right? So you are able to see, right? So people who pay themselves first, right? What is their income statement? So from the salary, they first invest on assets. That is, they save and invest, and then they carry out the remaining on expenses, taxes, rent, food, whatever. So people who pay everyone else first, from whatever income they get, they directly spend on their expenses and it goes off, right? So first, what is the main thing he tells? Invest on your assets. It's so many times it has happened that even Robert Kiyosaki, he was like, so many times he ended up in a position where he was like broke. He didn't even have much money to pay his bills. But still, he invested first on his education, first on his mind. Because of that, now we know like his money is working for him. That is what the bottom line is. If you want your money, make your money work for you, right? So after, like, even I was spending like this, but after going through this and we both together start spending around 15 to 20,000 every month on these things, whatever he tells. And even the bills part, like I was able to relate. Whenever the bill come, I used to pay it immediately. But now I pay when, if 20th is the last day, I pay on 19th or 20th. That's very important to invest on your mind, invest on your education, invest on yourself first. Okay. So this is what I wanted to speak, Kiran. Thank you so much.
Amazing, Karthik. One of the most important topic in the current scenario, because it is not easy what he told to apply consistently. But yeah, that is the secret of the financial intelligence. Wonderful, Karthik. Thank you so much for sharing. So, Xana, you'll go next. I'll spotlight. Yep.
Hello, everyone. Vishal has given so much of detailing about self-image, and Karthik has now spoken about money, and I'll be talking something related to, you know, it's like, it's a family of, I think, being successful. And I'm going to talk about dedication and discipline, responsibilities, emotion and education, attitude and motivation. Can someone guess what I'm trying to talk about? I'll be talking about dream. So D stands for dedication and discipline, R for responsibility, E for education and emotion, A for attitude, and M for motivation. So I'll be talking about a girl now. So the girl is me, and I will be talking about how one of the very important and very a sensitive dream of mine. First thing is, I am really thankful and grateful for my parents, because they have really input that seed of being, being recognized everywhere or being in the limelight, and always wanted to be around people and bringing happiness. I think that is more important. We are anyways around people, but bringing happiness is actually very sensitive and crucial. So this seed was laid in me about more than 2.5 decades ago. Well, I was 2.5 or 3 year old girl, and my dad always wanted me to be on stage. The reason being, his childhood was really tough. He got into a responsible life at the age of 13. He had 4 sisters, so it was difficult for my dad to pursue his dream or, you know, to live a life of an educated person. My dad does, you know, he still struggled a lot to complete his degree, but couldn't, due to his father's pressure. And my mom was a tennis court player, but she couldn't continue her dream. To be frank, both of theirs actually fed into me so deeply that today I play sports. I am amongst people. I can, you know, do whatever they have wished for. They always wanted me to be on stage. It could be, playing in an act, dancing, talking, everything possible. But it was not an easy start, because the dream was already fed into me, but to pursue it, it took a lot of effort. You know, while we are kids, it's okay. In school, we have a good encouragement. We start, we do it. And in college, we're still okay, but the connect between that is a little lesser than what it is in school. And continuing to corporate, when it came, it absolutely went down the graph, and it was difficult to push and come back to what my dream was, because in my early 20s, I even, you know, did a lot of event management. I did MCing. I always wanted to be on radio. I have also been on All India Radio. So all of these were there in my mind, and it never triggered to me until I met the right set of people. And to be frank, PIM, actually gave this, because when you think something different or something out of the box, they say, right, people throw stones against fruitful trees. So people were like, are you crazy? Why would you do, what a different job than what everybody does? And I actually went with that flow for some time, but it was there deep inside me that I need to come and show myself what I am. And today, the reason I wanted to bring this up is you will not get a lot of people who encourage on your dreams. So it is very important to take your association. So Vishal was talking about your association, right? The positive people. Now today, if I think last time when I spoke about imagination, I told about what my dream MRP is. I don't think Kiran ever would have thought and laughed at it. He would have actually felt proud, like, oh, they have actually thought out of the box. And it is important to write your dreams and actually start. I mean, give it some time to, kindle that fire in you of what you really want and what you really want to pursue. So this, when I did it, this platform, PIM platform, gave me the opportunity. And when I have been a state level player for, athletics and throwball and all. And PIM also has health community. So if you have health community, you have to be fit. So it immediately triggered my, emotion. And I'm happy that I'm able to help people in being healthy, having good hair, good skin. All of this was like, I didn't know. And when I started bringing in interest in it, it really helped me to figure out more, and it keeps me going. But I will talk about how it keeps me going only next week. So this is like a basic thing that I wanted to talk, but keep dreaming, stay around dreamers, don't give up, don't have that I have an excuse attitude. And I think that's what matters. This is what I wanted to share.
Amazing, Sahana. In fact, Rockstar Sahana movie part one is released. Now part two will be next week. So people who want to see the climax of the movie to come next week and listen to what Sahana speaks about it. Amazingly covered, Sahana. It was really awesome. The way you've spoken and the excitement and your stories is really inspirational. It really connects with all of us. Wonderful sharing, Sahana. Thank you so much. Great. So we have last couple of speakers now. I think we can take Vinay. Vinay, if you are available, I can spotlight you.
Yeah, Karthik. Yeah, Kiran.
Just a second.
Okay, I'm sharing my screen.
Do you have a better internet connectivity, Vinay? Shall I?
Yeah. I'm using broadband.
Achha.
But I'm unable to share.
I think you'll be able to share. Try it. I think you can share.
The support people will support you and how they will support. Okay, so first question, why we need the support of the peoples? There is a competitive market, right? Every place there are competitions. If you are not getting the support of peoples, you will not get the success. Why we need the support of peoples? Let's say you are a HR manager, and you need and there is a target. Every place we have a target, right? So if there is a HR manager and his leader told you need to hire this many number of people, and if you are failed to hire, and you are asked some documents will give some documents, okay, and if you are failed, then your leader will fire you. Okay, so without support, people will not get the success. Let's say there is a many rich people, and they are earning from different fields, just like a Mukesh Ambani. They are using Jio, Reliance Oil, and others. If people are not going to purchase their item, he will not become a rich person, right? So they need to support the people. So you replace people, people will support, then you can get the success. Then how to get the success is depend upon your behavior, your nature, your technical things, and other things as well. So there is a very important phrase. If you give the respect, then you can take the respect. Okay. So based on this, likability means how you are going to make the friends. Always talk to politely. Okay. and help to others and try to get all the opportunity. Don't miss any opportunity. Just like I will give one example. Let's say you already did one work and in front of person also did same work. Always try to price him. Anyway, you did a good job compared to others, but you have to price in front of person as well. So later, let's say he know, okay, you already know this, but you price him, he always try to make you as a friend. So always try to make friends and make the friends and follow the good people. Okay, if you are following the good people, you will get the your network will increase, right? So connectivity will increase and other things is also increase. So and always try to follow the good people. And there is also very important phrase, just like let's say a person who is the very good scholar may or may not be a good tutor, but an average person always be a good tutor. So put yourself in, if you're talking, put yourself in front of others. And if whatever you are telling, just put yourself, if I heard this word, what will happen to me? So for making the, conclusion is for making the success, you have to make the friends, you have to take the support from people. So yeah, that's all.
Superb, Vinay. I really like the talk and you covered in time. The best part of it is that. And the topic which Vinay covered is so essential. In fact, Think and Grow Rich, major chapter, I've been taking about multiple causes of failure. One of the cause of failure in your life is not being cooperative with others. So if you do not inculcate people skills, then the success is a bleak, you know, it'll look bleak for you. And you really nicely covered, Vinay. Thank you so much for sharing. Great.
Yes, thank you.
So I'll go next. Karthik, can you spotlight me? I have a very interesting part of last week. Awesome, great. So before I start, I need all of your help to summarize what kind of failure we have covered last week. So we covered almost 5 to 6 causes, the major causes of failure. So anyone, you know, can unmute and share what kind of causes we have covered quickly. पता चल जाएगा समरी में सबको अगर भूल भी गए तो सब याद आ जाएगा वापस. Okay, if you want me to help, I can also help. Lack of well-defined purpose. And aim above mediocrity, this is the one thing which I shared. What else? Who else can add? Cool. Yaad nahi hai logo ko. Aur kya ho sakta? Theek hai, guess hi kar lo. Best hai. You know, guess it off. What is the major causes of failure? Failure ke causes kya ho sakte hain? Guess kar lijiye aap.
Capital?
Lack of capital. Yeah, that's true. But that is one of the causes of failure. Pardon?
Action.
Okay. Persistence and lack of self-discipline. True. Or kuch? Inability to cooperate with others. We share kar diya. Humne ye bhi chale gaya. I think Vinay covered this content of it. Anything else?
Taking decision in the right time.
Okay. Haan, wo, I think wo wala failure main abhi lunga. That is one of the cause of failure, which I'll take now. Yeah, the other thing is insufficient education and intolerance. When people are close-minded for things, when we are not open for learning new things in life, that is when you're inviting another failure in your life. So pretty much that is what we summarized. And thank you so much for, again, remembering. Now I hope you won't forget. So we'll move to this. Another 4 major causes of failure. So there is a saying, you know, any problem is a problem when there is no purpose. And any problem is no problem when there is a purpose. I repeat, any problem is a problem when there is no purpose. Any problem is no problem when there is purpose. When there is purpose. So what I mean to say is, your problem looks a problem when you have no purpose. I'll give very simple examples. Almost few years in my life, I had a lot of, you know, for me, when I say problem, with God's grace, maybe I don't have much problems as such. But yeah, I realized ki when I started my own business, you know, business was not going good. I was not able to attract people. Main logo ko lead nahi kar pata tha. Skill ka gap tha. A lot of skill gap was there in my life. And also when I'm trying to build a team, again, the team is getting vanished. So I was lacking a lot of skill and a lot of leadership skills, people skills, which is causing me tremendous amount of failure. I'm putting so much of effort of hard work, but results are not at all coming. For simple, in terms of materialistic example, imagine you work hard for almost 2 years, spending each and every day for 4 hours, okay? 4 to 5 hours on an average. But in end of the 2 year, you're still not making even single money, single rupee aap nahi bana rahe ho. That was a mental torture I used to get because I used to feel ki I was already having a good degree, everything, but still why I'm not able to, you know, work my business out. So there was a lot of problem, but to be honest, I'll tell you honestly, I could today, when I look back, I see it was a problem, but actually I enjoyed so much. The purpose was so huge. Dreams were so big that I could never see that problem. It is a problem. Rather, I persisted. And whatever I achieved is because of the persistence, which I have achieved. Okay? So this is one quote, which I wanted to share. This is again, take care of one of the causes of failure. Okay? The other thing, another quote, truth like surgery may hurt, but it cures. Truth like surgery may hurt, but it cures. So now you'll know what are the surgery you need to make. So the first, again, the major cause of failure is ill health. Now I know ill health is a very pretty simple topic to understand, but let me share your story here as well. Now, unless you know a story around your life, you will never become motivated for your health. Let me share your story. So this was again 2 years back. I had a friend of mine who was working in SAP. And he used to be very excited. He was very young and you know, he's an I personality. He used to always speak and very jolly person. And he met me. And then what used to happen? I used to do a lot of health camp at that time. 2 years back, we used to do a lot of health camp in multiple parks and he used to participate in with us. But after some time, what happened? He could not persist. And usko wo motivation chala gaya. Bolta tha, Kiran, yaar, main toh already itna young hu. Why should I focus on health? And then I also couldn't motivate and influence much about him. I left it. What happened in one of the Monday morning, he went to office and one of his colleague was sitting in just front of him in the chair. And around 10:32 or 10:35 a.m., suddenly his colleague collapsed. Okay? And the moment he collapsed, then 108, he put 108 and that ambulance came and then they took it in ambulance. And it was so difficult. That guy was watching in front of eyes, that guy collapsed and he called ambulance and he was going with him. And before he reaches hospital, the guy dies. It's a true story, okay? And you won't believe it, what is the age of that particular guy who died? The age was just 29. And how did he die? He died out of cardiac arrest. So what I mean to say, guys, jab tak aap apne circle mein dhoondoge nahi ki kaun suffer kar raha hai, you won't be serious. If you just think for some time, how many people in your circle are suffering from maybe arthritis, BP, cholesterol, diabetes, you know, maybe some depression, anything, you won't value your health much. So look into it, then you'll get serious about it. So this is another cause of failure, ill health. The second thing, lack of enthusiasm and negative personality. Needless to say, right? Your height of success comes with depth of your conviction. Your height of success comes with depth of your conviction and your conviction comes out of confidence and enthusiasm. And the best part, I would needless to say, the reason this end of the talk is making sense because we saw so many wonderful speakers were so enthusiastically speaking. Sahana spoke very nicely. Bhushan was so, you know, inside his dream world and Vishal shared and so many people shared amazingly good. So they're very enthusiastic about the vision. And what was happening, because they're very enthusiastic about the vision, their personality also was very positive. If you see many of us, we are emitting positive vibration. And that is the biggest cause of failure. In fact, another example I will tell you, I don't know how many people know. So there was a company, the very popular company, which I'll reveal the brand. In 1906, the company was found. And there was two friends who started this company. It was a motorcycle company. Okay? Now you would have guessed. Now those company wanted to build something out of motorcycle and they came up with some innovative thing. And their idea became so popular in the World War II and World War I. They were like racing forward with the success. Almost 30, 40 years, nobody could stop them. After 50 years of time, what happened in around, I think 1960s, Japanese came into the picture. And they started building amazing motorcycles with less price and with more comfort and with more durability. And the moment that competition came, this brand of motorcycle got hit. And it got so badly hit that in just next 5 years, it was in a level where it was about to get shut down. Okay. And they were like about to give up. And fortunately, what happened while they were about to give up, the employees who were so passionate about that cause and about the idea which they're working with the company, there are 16 employees around board of directors can call or maybe higher management people. They took a decision that we will put all of our life savings to just to save this company. And being an employee, they put their life savings, 16 people, and they bought the company and started working on it again and again, again and again, again and again. And now that company valuation is so huge that every single year, it creates more than $2.9 billion of revenue. And that is a pre-COVID data. And you know what is the brand of the company? I don't know if you have guessed. It's Harley Davidson. And what was the secret of the company to sail through is actually enthusiasm. You won't believe it. Enthusiasm saved the company, that's all. And that is the power of lack of enthusiasm. So now you got another reason. The third one is lack of well-defined power of decision. There's again a quote here, Ben Franklin said, to succeed, jump as quickly at opportunities as you do at conclusions. Most of us, we judge people, we come up with conclusion, instant conclusion, we come up to it, but we take a lot of time to think if the opportunity is good, whether I should try. And we go with a lot of guessing instead of thinking. We go with a lot of opinions. We start, we become paralyzed with our own information and we never take decision. And you won't believe it, this is one of the most biggest factor. If you want to become successful, is you have to make the decision quickly and improvise in the journey. Agar aap decision lene mein deri karoge, then you will become paralyzed in your decision and you can never be able to put actions. So this is what is the most important aspect. The fourth part, in fact, I also have in my story, I have a lot of incident where I've implemented this. This is one of my strengths, I would say. Taking decisions, I take very, very fast. And then on and on, when the challenges come, I try to figure it out and maybe change the decision if required. And yeah, the fourth one is pretty interesting. For people who are married, anyway, for them, there'll be other solution for it. But people who are not married, maybe unke liye thoda sa hope hai, is that wrong selection of a mate in marriage. Can you believe it? This is one of the causes of failure, 30 causes of failure, which 500 affluent people in 1900 years back, they have told, choose your right partner when it comes to marriage. And what is that supposed to mean? In fact, when I read it, I was so shocked. Oh my God, this is also so important. I have to be very, very careful now. Now, what happens is that when you're marrying some person, it could happen that the other person is also good, you're also good, but there is a possibility that you're not able to bring harmony inside your relationship. And if you're not bringing harmony in your relationship, you won't believe it, failure is likely to follow. Moreover, it will be a form of failure that is marked by misery, unhappiness, and destroying all signs of ambition. क्यों आप सोच के देखो क्यों यार बहुत लोग के फैमिली में जब कोई बंदा शादी करता है इनिशियली तो बट एक्साइटेड रहता है बाद में ही गिव अप्स ऑन हिज ड्रीम क्यों क्योंकि इफ ही नेवर फिगर्ड आउट हिज होम टीम ही नेवर फिगर्ड आउट टू ब्रिंग हार्मनी इन हिज लाइफ एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट हिज ड्रीम स्लोली डाइल्यूट होके वो ड्रीम को त्याग ही देता है एंड दिस इज वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट कॉज पीपल गिव अप ऑन देयर ड्रीम बिकॉज दे डोंट हैव एनी हार्मनी इन देयर ओन रिलेशनशिप So just to summarize what I spoke, these are very deep points which I've covered. One is ill health. I again spoke about one of the story and you also find your own story which will inspire you to become more regular in health. And the best part is that, fortunately, Bharat himself leads our PIM community when it comes to health. So we as a community also have other community which believes who are passionate about health. If you want, you can again get the details from us and so that you can also be part of community and focus on your health. Other is lack of enthusiasm and negative personality. We talked about Harley Davidson's story here. And other is lack of a well-defined power of decision. We also talked about here how quickly you can take decision and rekindle it and going taking decision on facts instead of opinions. This is the third point which we covered. The fourth and final thing is wrong selection of a mate in marriage. So people who have already married, unke liye anyway, Chachu will cover next week how do you bring harmony in marriage so that you can work on it. So nothing to worry about it. So you're still safe. But people who are not married yet, at least who can take right decision with your coaches and mentor so that you can bring harmony in relationship and grow successful. So thank you so much, guys, for listening me out. So this is what I wanted to cover. Great. So I think we are done with proper time this time, although we started late. So superb. Cool. So before we end, I think we have a culture. So if I think just a second, I think people are there. We can take one more people. If everyone is fine, I can take one or two more speaker. I can take Saurav, I can take Rajendra also, but it's up to you because we have already 10:30. So aap bataiye, aap hi bataiye, it's up to you guys.
Okay, Kiran, next time I will speak.
Next time I will speak, Rajendra. And what about Saurav? You want to cover now? You can cover in case if you want.
No, sure, sir. I can cover also next week.
Okay, cool. So I think Saurav and Rajendra actually have very interesting topic. Saurav will talk about looking. I think Saurav ne already teaser diya tha ki why, how people get stuck in their life, in their own changul bolte hindi mein, changul mein phas chuke hain. Saurav phir batayega ki us changul se kaise bahar aana hai, ab dimag ko kaise unwire karna hai. And that is most interesting topic from what to say when you talk to yourself. And Rajendra ji, I think he has topic on how to build confidence and destroy fear. I think it suits his personality. He has lot of stories to share and those things we'll be sharing. So before we end, I think we can summarize. And if we have missed any introduction, people can unmute and share. Or else we can, I think, yeah, Gajanan has joined for the first time. Gajanan, you want to introduce yourself quickly?
Hi, this is Gajanan. And I'm a PhD student at Washington State University. And yeah, it's very interesting to see like people are discussing around book. And yeah, this is something I'm participating very in. Yeah, for first time. So yeah, excited to see you guys more. Yeah, in the next week. But yeah, today I joined late, so I missed lot of important thing. I hope next time I will be on time.
No worries. In fact, the best part I'll tell you, Gajanan is joining from the US, and uske in fact abhi kitna 8:30 ho raha hai. So before the book club started, he told me, Kiran, please call me once. So I called him, and fortunately he woke up and he joined. And really, it really amazed, man. The first time you're joining and still you could join, it's really nice, appreciable, man.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah. Great. Thanks for adding me.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Superb. So we'll quickly go for summary. So we'll have summary. We'll take around 3 more minutes to summarize quickly key points. So Prakash and Nasir, if you want, you can go ahead. And if anyone else want to add up, they can also add. It is not only for Prakash and Nasir. But yeah.
Yeah. So I'll summarize. Prakash, you're ready or?
So jo bhi summarize kar raha hai, uska chehra dikhna chahiye. You know, your video has to be on.
Okay. Yeah.
And now it feels
so. Okay. Yeah, so first Lalita ji started. So the law of attraction, so how to make correct choices, so to make our future bright. Then Charanjit from Rich Dad Poor Dad, third chapter, McDonald's story, and financials, how to bring financial freedom. Then Bhushan, our Iron Man, talked about his dream, how the imagination helped him to pursue his education and keep focus on his dream. Then I covered about think and grow rich, specialized knowledge about that. Then guest speaker Vishal, he suggested points to overcome low self-esteem. So the key points were, don't compare, focus on your self-improvement, have association with positive people, give back to the society, and past successful things, what we have done, we should keep visiting to make ourselves in a positive state. Then Karthik, he spoke about financial spending habits. So like we mostly spend on material things, but if we spend on the assets, that will make us financial free. Then Sahana spoke about the dedication and discipline. It's, in short, it's a dream, and there will be a part two next week. Then Vinay talked about magic of thinking big. Support of people is very much important to become successful. So we must appreciate and have company of good people. Then Kiran spoke about causes of failure. So 4 important causes of failure is ill health, enthusiasm, and quick decision making, lack of quick decision making, and selection of wrong mate. Yeah, I think that's all. If anybody wants to add anything on this.
Each and every time, even summary is getting so better. Very nice. Could anyone else want to add anything?